We're gonna skate to one song only.
It's the N-O-T-O-R-I-O-U-S. You just lay down slow.
K-I-A. Hey everyone, it's Kia again, and I'm here to show you guys how to make your very own pair of distressed jean shorts, or, you know, it can be used to make distressed jeans if you want to. Pretty much they're going to be high-waisted because I just like, you know, the vintage look, and they just look hotter than, you know, just plain, you know, jean shorts. Now you guys might be asking me, well, Kia, it's the fall. Hello. Why are you teaching us how to make distressed jean shorts? Well, critics, I wear distressed jean shorts all year around. They look great with everything. They're very versatile. In the winter or in the fall, you can wear them with, you know, stockings and, you know, thick thigh highs over top of them. You can wear them with your, you know, your favorite grunge or distressed boots. They're versatile from summer to spring to winter to fall all year round. And I don't follow trends as is. So I wear silk in the winter, suede in the summertime. I just do what I feel is right. I may mix a trend in, you know, here and there, but I'm not really trendy. I wouldn't classify my style as very trendy. It's just, you know, I'm free. I do what I please, and that's that. And I know this video is for everyone that, you know, does what they want and don't follow trends and just is an individual and is unique and does what they want to do. So, here we go. So, the biggest thing is to make sure you have a pair of non-stretchy jeans. That's the biggest thing. So here I have a pair that I brought from the local Goodwill for $5. I suggest you do the same unless you have a pair of high-waisted, vintage-looking old jeans laying around. Pretty much when you go to a thrift store, you just want to look for, you know, mom jeans. Pretty much the ones with the crotch is like super low right here, and like the zipper is kind of long. So typical mom jeans, when you put them on, it'll make your butt look extremely long. Like, when you put them on your waist, they'll make your butt look extremely long. But you want a high-waisted look, so you pull them up until the crotch meets your crotch. And that's how you try them on, make sure, you know, they fit right and everything like that. This is going to be the easiest, simplest way to make distressed shorts, period, across the board. I've seen tons of videos on how to make, you know, distressed jean shorts. And they had you, like, scrubbing, you know, scissors against a brick. They had you getting, like, sandpaper and rubbing, you know, continuously. They had, you know, running over with a car. Like, none of that. All you need is some scissors and a snip. Snip, snip, snip. That's it. No rubbing. No, none of that. So, just to get into it, I have, first things first, is get a pair of shorts. Here we go. Don't mind my room in the back. It's kind of messy and I'm handicapped, so I have an excuse. These are my favorite pair of distressed jean shorts. They fit the way I like, and the length is awesome. So find a pair of shorts that you like the length, and you're going to use that to measure up against the pair of pants that you just got. So here are the pair of pants. And why I say they have to be stiff like this is because if they're stretchy, when you go to do the cuts and you wash them, they come out, it's still going to be just one line. It's not going to be distressed at all. It's not going to fray. It's not going to do anything. So that's why they have to be, you see, stiff. It's not stretchy. I know you guys love your stretchy jeans, but for this, the stretch jean shorts, you need stiff jeans. Okay, so we have them. We're going to fold them in half as such. We're going to lay them flat on either, you know, your bed, the floor, if you have a table, all of that. So, get them right. Hand them flat. Turn this. So we have that as so. There. Then you're going to take your jean shorts that you love the length, and you're going to put them up. Also like Levi's, because Levi's are extra great. Like, their vintage quality is awesome, especially for making, you know, distressed shorts. They're amazing. That and Guess. So here, you measure right here. These are actually super, super short. So we're going to just bring it down just a little bit and cut. But normally you would just cut along that line. You want to make sure that you do not cut the seam of the jeans, because then you have, you know, a skirt, and we don't want that. So be conscious, be very conscious of where you're cutting. So because of these shorts are, you know, extra short and they don't measure completely up with these jeans, I'm just going to bring them down, you know, a little until I get to at least, you know, about an inch to 2 inches under, you know, that seam in the middle. And then I'm just going to cut along this line like so. Just cut along. I already have some shorts that I pre-cut, so I'm going to use those instead of, you know, cutting these. Because I'm not sure exactly if I want to make these distressed jean shorts or not. They make great, you know, boyfriend jeans. So that's another good plus, you know, with going to the thrift store and buying mom jeans. They make great boyfriend jeans. So I have these, you know, guest ones that I pre-cut. And the last video I was doing, like, cut off, my battery died. It's already, like, pre-cut slits and stuff like that. So, but I'm going to get into that, show you guys how to do that. So I cut these, and I like the guest ones because they actually have the buttons right here that you automatically know they're supposed to be high-waisted. And also, like, you know, the triangle on the butt, that's definitely vintage. So we cut these like so. So they match up to these. Actually, these are a little shorter. I mean, a little longer. So we cut along that line, and there we have it. I washed these already because I was wearing them, you know, just as these. So I'm going to turn them into distress now. So this is how they're going to look once you wash them. Even on the little, you know, distress parts. So you can, if you have a pair of distress jeans, you can use them as a guide of to where you want to make the slits and things like that. So I'm going to use this as a guide. Where are my scissors? Okay. So lay them flat. Close. I already cut these two slits right here. Three slits, I should say. And this is what you want to do. You just want to make a cut and measure and go across however long you want that distressed patch to be. Because when it's done, it's going to come out looking, you know, like this. You want to make sure you stay away from the pocket. This is how it's going to look. And make sure the slits that you're making aren't too small and not too big. I mean, it's better if they're bigger because once you wash them, you can go back and cut them to make them smaller. But make sure that they're not too thin because if they do, it's going to just turn into, you know, one big hole. And that happened to an actual pair of jeans that I made. But, you know, I finagled it a little bit and, you know, I made them look dope. So, that's that. So, you have the slits in it. Now, we're going to make, you know, some more slits. I want more slits on this one. So, then we're going to find the place that we want it. Cut a slit, then go the entire length of the jeans. I mean, not the jeans, the slits, the previous slits you made. You know, make sure that you do not cut the other slits because they look right. So we have these like three flaps right here. I think I'm gonna leave them like this for now. You may wanna, you know, make more, but I'm going to make these completely distressed, so we'll have other opportunities. So that's this patch right here. I made it right there. Then we're going to see the smaller patch. You're going to make that one, like, right, probably about an inch below, inch and a half below the pocket. So we're going to make it right there to match this one right here. And these are the slits that we just finished making. Show you how thick they are. Not really that thick. There. Okay. So again, stay within the pocket. You might want to take the pocket and actually if you can turn it inside out, but you can't turn it inside out. So start somewhere in the middle. Always want to start in the middle of the line that you want to make. Make sure the pocket is not a part of it. You want to snip. Just go. You can use a pair of thinner scissors. I'm using these hair scissors, which are bad. Another pair. So make these tinier slits. Make it across. Jean shorts. See, I made this one little flap right there. Then we're going to make another cut. Gonna make it, I say, above this one. Doing the same technique. Don't make them too thin. Snip. Then go across. Like so. so. And then we're going to make another one underneath that one. Underneath the first slit that we made. Like that. Go directly across. Keep in mind making sure they're all the same length. Those are the other slits that we just made. You can make more if you want. I'm going to leave it like this for now. Then we're going to see there's some fraying along the pocket line. We'll get that at the end. There's also some fraying up there. So we're going to get the big parts now. Now we're going to go to the other side of jeans and just basically do the same thing we did, but just like place them in opposite places. Now and I have the slits or where I put my distress marks at, and so I'm gonna throw them in the washing machine now and the dryer, and we'll be back shortly. Okay. High-waisted jean shorts, just like we made them. They're lovely, and yours will come out the exact same way we follow the instructions. So afterwards, you can definitely add some more distress patches, because I think I'm going to do that over, over here. I'm going to add some more or whatever. So here's what we did, the pocket and everything like that. So these are actually, I'm going to make available in my online store. It's www.dopesince1986.bigcartel.com. So definitely check that out if you want these. I think I'm gonna make them probably around, 15 or so, I guess. So that's that. If you have any questions, let me know, and I hope yours come out just as great as mine. And be sure to check out more videos, check out my blog, check out my online store, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.